Right, so I've decided to try and investigate this crane some more. So can't find any user manuals from Marklin or Trix to show the exploded view of this crane. So anyway, I've had a look. I'm virtually 99% sure it's a dedicated surface mounted permanent type chip that's built onto the PCB, because it's got the dip switches. I don't know if you can see dip switches there, and anything that's got dip switches usually means a dedicated chip which you can't take out off the board, which is I might not be able to retrofit this with a new chip. And I've tried resetting it, it just will not read the chip, so I'm taking out the power feeds. The power feeds are clean, and all the wheels are nice and clean. It's just stopped working for no reason at all. So I'm going to take off these bogies and see if there's any other way you can get disassemble it to investigate. So there's a screw there, and there's a screw here. I mean, these just pop out very easily, as you can see, and that gives you access to two screws. Right, so further investigation. I took the bogies off and shown the dip switches, which I'm going to leave because it's nothing to do with the dip switches. And it will be a surface mounted dedicated chip inside that. It's a 20 year old model, so it was way ahead of its time when this came out. It is way ahead. But it was at the time where Marklin were doing a lot of hard fitted surface mounted chips in various different coaches and trains, specialist trains and coaches and wagons. The other example is the torpedo blast furnace wagon that had a rotating drum on it. That was a dedicated surface mounted chip. It'd be similar on this. Anyway, I've discovered that it's got a bent contact there. I don't know if you can see it, but that will cause a short on the chassis. Right, this is quite scary. I've undone four bolts on the underside, on the back end of it, and I've lifted up. It's like a bonnet. It sort of lifts up. This area here slides forward, and underneath there's two motors. And I thought there might have been a decoder there, but there's no decoder, which has surprised me. So I'm not going to mess around with that anymore. I'm going to put that back and try and investigate somewhere else. Don't know where the decoder is. It might actually be built into the bogey. But yeah, so we've got... That's a bit of a surprise. So anyway, I've investigated further. I took out the pinion screws for the middle. There's like a middle cog. Those two tiny screws secure the top section to the pivoting motor system below, and it's only those two screws that hold it. Without them two, it won't turn, it won't bite the cogs properly. I really do recommend not to touch those screws, because it took me an hour to get them back in. Because the pinion drops and you've got to be very, very accurate to get those screws back in, because they're threaded, they've got to be lined up perfectly, and you've not got to over tighten them as well. Over tighten them, that's it. And I've managed to, you've got to put one in slightly and then the other, and you've got to maneuver the lower gearing section. It's really, really tricky. Like I say, it took me an hour to understand how to get them back in again without damaging them. So anyway, even though taking those two out, it won't lift off the framework, won't the top end won't lift off the bogey. So we've got two motors, I think two or three motors inside this area. No, sorry, two motors here, one for up and down on the jib and one for the boom. Then we've got another motor somewhere around here to turn the crane 360. But where that DCC chip is actually inside, it's buried in the bogey. How they put sound in this model, because there's a sound version of this model, how they got the sound in, I don't know. It's just unbelievable. It's put together in the most highly precision way, and it's all high quality. It's just unbelievable. I took off the side rails on the side because it's much easier to handle without the side rails. It's, I tell you what, it's an unbelievable bit of kit, but it's just a shame. The chip is so difficult to get to, and there's no diagrams anywhere showing on the internet. That pivots, you've got to make sure that you don't break that pivoting system. You've got to make sure you put back the pulley systems on the two centre pulleys, and they're not like tagged or snagged in any way. So the next thing to do is probably have another a little slight investigation on the lower bogey section to see if we can get to that decoder, but it's pretty much going to be a waste of time because it's going to be a surface mounted chip anyway, so I might have to just put it back and leave it as a static model, which is a damn shame. Well, there we go. Now to get to the circuit board, you've got to take off the bogies of contacts, take two screws out, then position them in that position with the legs back, just to keep them out of the way. And then this is a plastic shielding which will pop off, so I'm going to try and get that off next. Here's the moment of truth. You just manipulate, you just pull up, put a screwdriver in these slots and angle it, one there and one there, them square slots, and then the board, that plastic board pops out. And in there is the dedicated PCB mounted chip, and there's a motor that turns it. And if that motor isn't lined up with a cog above, it's not going to turn right. There's three more screws, and that'll show the slim chip that's inside it. Just looking at the wiring. Anyway, that's what we're looking at. Yeah, so when I took the three screws out for the PCB, and it's a dedicated chip. So it is possible to rip out all that board and put in an interface. Let's do away with all that board. Put a lock. Could probably put a lock sound 5 in there in that space quite easy. Just do away with all that circuitry board, and that will be the way forward with this model, because that chip's definitely failed. All the wiring's fine. Right, so I know how to get to everything now and how to put it back properly. The two screws that go in through the top are secured. They go into the motor there. But without taking the plate off, you can't reposition. It's really difficult to reposition the motor to get the screws in on the top, the two screws. Yeah. So there it is, it's back on its display stand. I've checked all the connections, all the wheels. The connections going to the PCB are fine, everything's all, no dry joints. So it is, it's got to be the chip that's failed on it. It's been sat on a siding with the power going through it for years. And obviously that must have done something to the chip, even though the chip looks fine. There's no like heat marks on the chip or anything, but the next stage is to strip it all down again and install Lock Sound 5 or just a standard lock pilot chip with probably with an interface as well that would fit, just about fit inside the bogey section. But anyway, other than that, that's where we're up to on this model. Hope it helps someone anyway. Thanks.